And Wren, this is a holiday on the Welsh Shropshire for teenagers of 11 to 15 years old. This is a view of some of the grounds where we're staying. This is the gymnasium area, and beyond that fence there is a swimming pool. This is the main accommodation area where the young people are staying.
Hello, Mr. Cameraman.
Yes, you're on film.
Huh?
Yes, you're on film. This is the dining room area where the meals are taken. And down there again is the swimming pool.
Yeah.
This is the morning of the second day, and here we see a game of bounders. Very interesting. That's just one of the leaders there. That's another of the leaders there. This is the room used for meetings in the evening, for singing and for teaching. And there's a small bookstore here with various books that people can buy. In the van. Do you want it? I can't see how close you are.
Oh, God. That's a good one.
Right, you ready to all look nice for the camera? You're on film now.
railway one over there?
Yeah, I think so. Good morning, this is the third day and we now have too many buses to take the kids from place to place. We now have a short time in the morning, starting each day, when we have a quiet time for children to talk and reflect about aspects of Christian life.
What everybody else has been is doing, they have already done this. The rest of the groups have covering this. I suspect some of you have already got these notes at home, one to one, whatever else. I suspect you might have used them, you might not have. I'm going to have my own personal opinion about them. And the grammar, etc. as I was reading through them. They're probably a little bit younger. I would suspect they are definitely a little bit.
That's the dog. Sorry. Stop a bit. Just have another view of part of the Quinta and the grounds surrounding the Quinta.
Oh. Stop complaining. You're being here.
You're not the one squashing.
You're the one squashing here. Well, I'm not. So take some more.
Look,
I've got
it back. The other side of the cross.
This is one of the loads of returning on the canal boat through the church tunnel. Big branch coming up. This is a visit to a Welsh slate mine. Some of the old slate trucks there. And here's the group that's coming out of the slate mine.
This is inside the museum, a model
one of the mountains
of old Saint Mary's. This is a night's camp out by the slate mines, just putting the tents up.
Where are they?
I had to put a tent up.
Hello, Luke. Hey, I'm a bit of
help.
Not even a ground sheet, I'm so disgusted.
We were told there'd be ground.
Put their junk on the floor and hold the box over. What you have may not be precisely the same as I've got, but you've got something that is very, very, very... No, beef and... Sorry, steak and onion casserole, or somebody else who's got mince steak. There are three different menus. So the menu... Shush, please. The menu and the instructions are inside the plastic pack or...
Where is the... What did I say? Where is the... You start up. Where... Go on, your son.
Where
is the water? Water.
So I'm just working who's the king of the jump and jungle. I've got that joy down in my heart. He's doing a solo.
It doesn't work.
And we have not. As we can see, this is totally defeated the object. The burning fuel has gone onto the grass and it's no longer in the cooker. But this isn't a problem.
Yeah, let's see.
What are
you doing?
Put it on the wrong way.
Well,
I'm going great, actually.
Over by the seat. Use only one of those blocks.
Here, camera. I don't know, Drake.
Does it taste nice?
No, great.
Jill, do we eat it warm now or cold tomorrow morning for breakfast?
No, this is lovely.
You've got some pizza puppies and you're standing down in the
Thank you.
keep his majesty.
Says, I can find the next place. Peter says that he was a witness to Jesus. He lived with him. He was a good witness for lots of time. And he never saw Jesus sin at all. Jesus never did anything wrong. He always did what God wanted. So whereas all of us keep doing things wrong, we don't seem to be able to help it, Jesus never ever did anything wrong. And that was by someone who was with him for so long, Peter, who knew him very well, perhaps more than anyone else knew him on earth. And if someone was going to bridge the gap between God and ourselves as human beings, it needs to be someone who is God and is a human being, someone who can put their foot on both sides of the bridge, of the chasm. And Jesus, we believe as Christians, wasn't just a human being, wasn't just a very good human being, a very good teacher. He was actually God who came down to live on earth. And the fact that Peter can say Jesus never ever sinned seems to me to say, well, that man Jesus is far more than an ordinary man. He's far more than an ordinary human being. He's actually God in human flesh. And that's how the Christians in the New Testament and Christians today believe Jesus to be.
Thank you. If you go that way, and then Barlow to the A5, and then the A5 to church.
I thought I might go up to
if you go that way. Go through the forest.
There's a map in the...
There's a map in the
van.
Six Rona.
A map in one of the vans.
There's two maps in the...
I'm going to get my information.
Now?
My, we're glad to be here. How happy to be here. Keep it up.
Life is sweet.
No, of course not. What do you mean?
To trust me.
with all you have, even your life.
My life?
Yes, I want you to live my life, full life. I have a plan for you, and that is... about this man's life and see how his trust in God and his obedience of God's laws thank you Katie for the stinky his obedience in God's laws actually meant that he could see in the end that God had been with him the whole time through. Now if you're in a position where you can't see the television, I advise you to
This is the early morning 6:30 swim, just to show what sensible people his crusader holidays are.
Oh, I love it.
That's why I started shooting as soon as
the
Would someone like to start reading? Read a verse each. So starting at verse 19, read a couple of verses each. Daniel, would you like to start with verse 19?
Find it? Yep, where is it? Two verses each.
Yeah.
They are going to end up in hell because they've got...
No. Philippians 2, verse 19.
If it is the Lord's will, I hope that I will be able to send Timothy to you soon, so that I may be encouraged by news about you. He is the only one who shares my feelings and who really cares about you.
Everyone else is concerned only with his own affairs, not with the cause of Jesus Christ. And you yourselves know how he has proved his worth, how he and I, like the son and his father, have to work together for the sake of the gospel.
So I hope to send him to you as soon as I know how things are going to turn out. I trust in the Lord that I myself will be able to come to you soon.
I thought it necessary to send your brother Epaphroditus, who has worked and fought by my side and who has served as your messenger in helping me. He is anxious to see you all and is very upset because you had heard that he was ill.
Indeed he was ill and almost died. But God had pity on him, not only on him, but on me too, and spared me an even greater sorrow. I am more than more eager than to send him to you, that you will be revived again when you see him, and my own sorrow will disappear.
Welcome him, Lord, with great joy and show your appreciation, for he risked his life for the work of Christ. He was at the point of death for trying to do for me the things you couldn't do because you were far away. So, would someone like to, Daniel, would you like to read all of the thing in the actual book?
Okay. A little bit of verse 22 that starts with.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. He and I have worked together for the sake of the gospel. Do you have a good friend? What is a genuine friend like? Jot down the qualities you think are important in friends. It may help think of your best friend and describe that person. Are you doing that?
Yeah. Well, just read the rest now.
Paul was a strong character, but he still needed one or two close and loyal friends like Timothy and Epaphroditus. In particular, Paul valued the following friendship qualities. Someone who shares his feelings and is really concerned about his friends, verse 20. Someone who works in close partnership with him for the sake of gospel, verses 22 and 25. The church is a place where we can make genuine and lasting friends.
Thank you.
sort of blip those tins.
Blip?
Yeah.
Can you hold it up?
Okay,
Not attracted by the other two across the road.
Sorry?
Ah, right.
I'm not sure if he's coming to the dog or not. No splashing much. Let it stop.
Ready for the screen.
Crazy rain.
Come on. You're going on it?
Yeah.
Hi, Liz.
Hi.
Hi, Liz.
So, so is John.
John is.
Hello.
It's a big queue.
It's a massive queue.
Daniel!
No! Go away,
Luke been on.
Bit
my shoulder.
Go easy on the cheek.
Do it slow.
These are Leanne and Joe. Should I smile? Oh, move! It's not on.
Yeah, so
it's not on.
It is.
Is it right then? It's not. Don't. It is on. It's red beat. It's not on.
Right, are you ready with your pose?
Yeah.
Shut up.
Very nice.
Adrian's got a gorgeous scar right in the middle. Right, that's not bad really either. So, Charlie got zero stars.
Stop knocking into this one.
Simon, you can see you have one.
Is that straight? She's right. Standing like that.
I think that's a four.
Oh, it's more knobbly.
It's so lovely. It's a bit more knobbly, really.
Yeah.
It's been five, really. So that's a five. But
I thought you were going to be able to help me fathom out what my dream means. About a great tree that flourished and provided food and shelter for many animals. Then, on God's command, it was cut down and all its goodness scattered to the wind. The stump of the tree was bound with iron and bronze and left in the
spirit of all the holy gods in you, and all the new can.
This statement is theologically most unsound, but Daniel was so struck by the meaning of the dream, he appears not to have noticed. In fact, he sat dumbfounded for a whole hour.
Daniel! Daniel! Wakey, wakey! Is the meaning so awful you can't tell me what it is? Quick, spit it out, man, and put me out of my misery!
If only the dream that you had was about some enemy of yours. But, sir, I fear that
back to earth.
got married and had Natasha. I married a young man from Christian home as well. But I think in a way he was giving up his faith and his Christianity. And the marriage was breaking down, and the marriage broke down eventually. And then in a way I felt like I was a bit lost myself in that. And I've since found a great relief to develop my own Christianity. So I think latterly in my life I am going deeper into my own development.
This is the final day of the holiday with a visit to the local leisure centre for swimming, roller skating and various other activities.
Chair out.
Not round yet.
Oh, they sit
there
for Katie.
Oh, all right. Yeah.
Katie, you're
going
to
pick out
some.
No,
you don't
have me.
Oh, I don't know who I can
find.
I've got my purse
in
it, nothing in it. I haven't got mine, but there's some change in it, but I don't care.
So
I'm not
Well,
we'll
take
a picture.
Look, he's taking pictures.
He's got that thingy.
Yeah.
Right, everybody else.
It's over.
Everybody else.
Where's the shop?
Oh, yeah. Another shop.
story. Not a story.
REC. I press it again.
Did you make it?
Precisely! You are
something, it's a dress, an evening Michael, dress occasion.
Take it back to speeches.
Or formal, but it must be dressed properly.
Michael, take it back to speeches.
Anybody?
This is one of our cooks who's just about to tell us what he's cooking for supper tonight.
This is for Leanne. It is a packet of refreshers, pressed toothpaste, and biscuits. And we will make a sandwich.
This is our chief cook, Jill, who's been cooking for us for the week. So Jill, have you enjoyed this week here?
I certainly have.
And have you cooked on these holidays before?
I've cooked on one before, last year.
And you normally have a family to cook for at home, do you?
I do, yeah. And I cook, I just sort of multiply it up and do what I would do at home. I'm not really a professional.
Okay, thanks very much, thank you. And is this Colgate or McLean's, I wonder?
The best.
Oh, it's pressed. Only
yes,
pressed.
Makes your teeth clean.
And here we have burnt toast, and more burnt toast, and still more burnt toast. Here we have another of our cooks, this is Roz. Roz, would you like to say a word to the video?
Hello, yes, welcome to the
slate.
That one.
It's Britannia.
Right. you've been cooking on this holiday as well, have you?
Yes. Very nice.
And do you work as a cook normally, or what do you do normally?
Actually, I'm a student. You might get
a student. All right.
We have a cassock borrowed from Father the Reverend himself here. We have a nice flag, courtesy of Michael, the organiser of the camp. Tennis racket, or designer tennis racket, which belongs to Christopher, the son of the Reverend. Flip-flops belonging to myself, which are very nice. And rubber ring that is the possession of the daughter of the Reverend, who herself is called Hannah. I think that's all.
Okay,
slate please. Earrings, common to the theme of this holiday. Yes, and so thank you and good night.
Right, thank you. And this is, in fact, here is a curate, you see, who is using shaving foam. Would you like to, which parish is it that you're a curate of?
I refuse to have all that information on the camera.
And this here is the curate's wife.
Typical Vicar's wife, really.
Yeah, he comes from a very nice shop locally.
It's our wedding.
Yeah. Oh dear.
Right, Daniel, could you tell us about this Crusaders holiday? Have you enjoyed yourself?
Yeah, it's been really good. The activities were good.
What sort of activities have you done during the week?
Been on trips to Alden Towers and on a canal boat. A lot of games and the like. It's been very good fun. Enjoyable.
Yeah. And have you been on other Crusader holidays before?
I went to this holiday last year.
Well, the same place as this?
Yeah. And Sandalman of the year before.
Yeah. So obviously you must like that you come back for other holidays. You must like them. Yeah. Does this holiday help you in your Christian faith, do you think, or this sort of holiday?
Well, every year it's helped me in my Christian faith. It's strengthened me a lot. This year's boosted me a lot because I'm getting baptised in a few months and it's sort of boosted my confidence a lot more.
Right. And would you recommend these holidays suitable for non-Christians, or would they feel totally out of place?
Well, no, they wouldn't be out of place because there are quite a few non-Christians on them. I mean, there aren't as many as this year as there were last year. But often people do become Christians on these holidays. And it's a lot of fun without, I mean, if you just come along for fun. I mean, if you come along thinking that you don't want to go listen to the Bible, but it's a bit of a negative approach. But
I mean, they're not that long, and so people who really don't want to listen to them won't be that bored of them, and they'll really enjoy it either way.
Okay, thank you very much, Daniel. This is Michael Prosper, an intrepid holiday leader, and his wife here. This is another of the leaders, Margaret, here. And another leader there.
I haven't done it yet.
Thank you.
Skyping Candace. But I thought it'd be really good on our last night. That we could actually, I think a lot of us feel that maybe, hopefully, we've learned something, even if it's how many Beatles there in the wherever. How many Beatles, species of Beatles, whatever. Hopefully we've learned some stuff about God too. In our quiet time and time that we've had meetings together. And I thought it'd be really nice, before we all leave to go home tomorrow, that if anybody in particular wanted to share something that God's taught them this week, something that they really want to thank God for, however you think it might be really small or really massive or, you know, something that maybe we won't know as a group, because one thing about being Christians is that we are a family together, and it's really good to encourage each other.
So, it's bound to be a sham. When you go home, it's bound to disintegrate, and you'll end up pretending. If you want a Christian life that's not pretending, you need to have very solid foundations. And it seems to me that for a decent, solid Christian life, we need three things. It's like a stool. Christian life is like a stool with three legs. And take one of those legs away, and the whole thing will collapse. We need prayer. We've just been praying. We've just been thanking God. But prayer is more than just thanking God. It's confessing our sins. It's praying for other people. It's praising God. It's asking God to help us in our life. It's talking to God. It's talking to God as if you were a good friend, just like you would talk to the person sitting next to you. It's listening to what God's saying. It's a two-way process, and it's very important to grow. You can't get to know each other unless you talk to each other. That's why you've been talking incessantly the last week to each other, to get to know each other a bit more, to know more things about each other, to know God more, to be a better Christian, to live a better Christian life. You've got to talk to him, to share with him what you say, and to listen to what he's trying to tell you. And we can do this, as Luke reminded us, through the power of the Holy Spirit. So that's prayer. And Bible study. If you want to hear what God's saying to us, why not pick up his word and read it? This Bible is God's word to each one of us. It's got so many things in it that we can learn from. We can pick it up and read it and hear what he's got to say for each one of us. Learn more about what he's done in the past. Learn how to live. Learn what his rules for life are. Learn what Jesus' example was. And learn to live like him. And again, it's the Holy Spirit that gives us that power to learn from God's word, learn from the Bible. And the last one is fellowship. Being with other Christians. It's great on a holiday like this. There's Christians all over the place. We can just wake up in the morning and share in our dormitories, talking about the Christian faith with each other. But perhaps when you get home, it's not so easy. Maybe you're the only Christian in your family. Maybe you're the only Christian in your class at school. Perhaps there's not a very lively church in your town. Maybe when you go to church, there's no one you can really talk to about your Christian faith. There's no one who can be your agony aunt in the Christian faith there. But it's very important that we should meet with other Christians to learn from each other's experiences. That's what I enjoy about these holidays. I can learn from other Christians, from the leaders, and from you. Learn about your experiences of God and learn more about God for myself. And meet together for worship, to praise God together, and to sing and pray together. Those are the three foundations of the Christian life. Take any one of those away, and the stool won't stay up for long. It'll just...
Daddy, go!
Right,
Daddy,
go!
Geraldine, you're going to call out our contestants and introduce us to them. So would you do that for us now?
Okay, right. First we got Roz. Okay, this is Roz, who is from Southern on the Wolf, and she's a magazine geologist.
Yes. They did? Walls of Jericho. I'm sorry. Okay, a technical question for you. What is... We have to say farewell to Naomi, who's a very brave contestant.
Sweet tooth. They put it in their coffee. Are you British tea as well?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Oh,
She could be spoiled out there.
No, she's not.
You
don't
need a roofie. Very, very nice. Getting on the barge, off the barge.
getting such the canoes everywhere that we've both been at the right time this week. Goes to Michael, and I'm sure you'll join me in thanking him for all his organisational skills and abilities and getting us such an enjoyable programme this week. And also to Sheila, who's been a tower strength behind us, looking after all of our money, not just your bank, but also all the camp finances, and making sure that all of our suppliers get the right checks at the right time for the right amount. So I'd like to thank you both for all your hard work, Michael and Sheila. Thank you. Never any